We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Lamb of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Welcome po dito sa Minor Basilica of Our Lady of Manaoag. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. Hear in kindness, O Lord, the prayers of your people, that those who rejoice at the coming of your only begotten Son in our flesh may, when at last he comes in glory, gain the reward of eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Shout for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away from your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, "Fear not, O Zion, be not discouraged. The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you, as one sings at festivals." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Exalt your just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Give thanks to the Lord on the harp, with ten string lyre chant his praises. Sing to him a new song, pluck the strings skillfully with shouts of gladness.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
But the plan of the Lord stands forever, the design of his heart through all generations. Bless the nations whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. For in him our hearts rejoice, in his holy name we trust.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Please stand. Emmanuel, our King and Giver of Law, come to save us, Lord our God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out in those days and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leapt in her womb and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Minsan may isang ina na nanganganak, at habang siya ay nanganganak, sa sobrang sakit na kanyang naramdaman habang lumalabas ang bata, inapasigaw siya at sinabihan niya ang doktor, Dok, sobrang sakit po, pakibalik po muna. Yun po naman ay kwento lamang na narinig ko, pero hindi ko po sure kung nangyayari po yun sa totoong buhay. Madalas po, yung pagbubuntis ay binibigyan natin ng imahe ng sakit. Binibigyan natin ng imahe ng mukha ng isang ina na umiiyak, sumisigaw. Minsan nakakalimutan natin na ito rin ay imahe ng matapang na babae. Ito rin ay imahe ng lakas at grasya. Yung panganganak, pagbubuntis, is not only about making babies. Ito rin po ay making of mothers. Nung binisita ni Maria si Elizabeth, yung inalala ni Maria, hindi lamang po yung hirap na pwedeng danasin ni Elizabeth sa panganganak sa ganung edad, matanda na, nabuntis pa. Hindi lang mang yun ang inaalala ni Maria, sapagkat sigurado siyang mahihirapan. Binisita niya si Elizabeth para din ipahayag na ito ay kalooban ng Diyos, na nang dahil sa mga iyon ay matutupad ang pinaplano ng Diyos. It is part of God's plan, creation. Minsan iniisip ko po, ano kaya ang nasa isip ng isang ina habang nasa tuktok sila ng sakit, habang nanganganak? Ano kaya ang laman ng isip nila? Siguro minsan, no, makakarinig ka ng storya na binabanggit nila yung pangalan ng asawa nila na may galit. Yung parang, Bartolome, humanda ka, pagkatapos nito, huwag kang magpapakita sa akin. O di kaya, pwede kaya nating sabihin sa kanila na you are participating in God's plan. Siguro po, very understandable na sa kalagitnaan ng sakit na nararamdaman ng isang ina, eh talagang mapapasigaw siya sa kanyang nararamdaman. Ilan ho kaya tayo dito sa loob ng simbahan? Imaginin mo kung yung bawat ina na yon, sabay-sabay tayong niluwal. Siguro yung maririnig natin sa simbahang ito ay parang mga kambing at baboy na nagsisigawan sa sobrang sakit. Bagamat ganun po, huwag po natin kalimutan, it is a participation of God's plan, the plan of creation. Nawa, tulad ni Maria, bawat ina na magbubuntis at manganganak ay kayang sabihin sa gitna ng sakit, The Lord has done great things for me, and holy is His name. Magsitayo po tayo. Elizabeth was honored by the visit from the mother of her Lord, but Mary only wished to share her joy. Let us bring our prayers to the Father who cherished these chosen women. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. that the Church be zealous in spreading the good news of salvation to all people, especially to those in far-flung areas. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders show special concern for the poor and the marginalized by their programs and services. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That families and communities show gratitude for their individual and communal blessing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That like Mary, we as a community and as individuals strive to reach out to our neighbors who are in dire need for our material and spiritual assistance. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead experience the joy of God's presence in His kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. In silence, we also pray for our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, you manifest your presence among us in the generosity of our brothers and sisters. May we continue to proclaim your love by engaging in a life of service. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your Church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Socrates our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Please stand.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
bigyan mo kami ngayon ng aming kakanin sa araw-araw, at patawarin mo kami sa sa tuwa.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but at the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Paalala po sa lahat, sa inyong pagtanggap ng communion, bago humarap sa magbibigay ng communion, pakibaba na po ang face mask. Kapag sinabi sa inyo, Body of Christ, tanggapin ng inyong dalawang kamay ang hostya at sumagot ng Amen. At isubo na agad ang hostya. Huwag po ninyong isubo habang naglalakad at lalong huwag dalhin sa upuan ang hostya upang maiwasan po ang pagkahulog nito. Salamat po. Please stand.
Let us pray. Lord, may participation in this divine mystery provide enduring protection for your people, so that being subject to your glorious majesty in dedicated service, they may know abundant health in mind and body. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalo sa ating banal na misa. Mag-ingat po tayo sa ating pag-uwi. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Ngayon po ay pagdasal natin yung ating mga mahal sa buhay na may sakit. God, our Almighty Father, by your blessing, you give us strength and support in our frailty. Turn with kindness toward our sick brothers and sisters. Feed them from all illness and restore them to good health through the intercession of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, so that in the sure knowledge of your goodness, they will gratefully bless your holy name. We ask this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer for the blessing of rosaries and other religious articles. Pakilabas po kung meron po kayong mga dala. In memory of the mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the honor and glory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Christ, Mother of the Church, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, may these rosaries, images, candles, oil, and other religious articles be blessed and made holy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.